What is up, guys? Steven here, and today I'm going to bring you more ranked Splatoon gameplay. So last night, I live-streamed, a new map came out, Camp Triggerfish, which you can see on your screen now. And I really like the new map. It's really fun, and it's different than most of the other maps in that most of the maps are comprised of, like, your spawn, their spawn, and the middle. Whereas this map is more of a left and a right side, and you don't have access to the other side until there's a minute left in the game. So it's kind of interesting in that way. The current game mode is Tower Control, which I'll get into in Recon. But of course I want to show my class first. Once again, I'm using Tentatec Splatter Shot because it's my favorite gun to use on Tower Control, as the suction bomb is really good, as you can put them onto the tower. And it's just a good all-around weapon. I'm using the snorkel mask just because I want to increase the power of my suction bomb, so I can pretty much guarantee kills on the tower with suction bombs. This shirt decreases the amount of ink that I need to use to throw suction bombs, and also increases the range of throwing suction bombs. And these shoes are ink resistant because I feel like it's the best ability that shoes can have, followed closely by stealth jump, and it has swim speed up, which is pretty nice. It'll help me get back into the action quickly. Alright, so I want to go into Recon and basically just explain Tower Control. This is the other most recent map that came out, Moray Towers, and this map is incredibly vertical. As you can see, you basically just can jump all the way down to the middle. So I'm going to jump off just so I can show a pretty key thing about this map. So Tower Control, basically the goal is to get the tower from one end of the map to the other. So in general, at the beginning of the game, I'm going to jump to this level. Most of my teammates will continue to jump down there to the middle, but I'm going to go this way because this is a really key path that you need to be able to get down quickly. So as you can see by this line that's on the ground, that's the path that the tower is going to take. So the tower is going to come along here and up here and come over here, right? So it's really important to be able to get to this point on the map quickly, because this is the first major choke point of the tower, because basically once you get around this corner, it's pretty difficult to prevent the opponent from getting momentum up this hill. And this is the final resting place of the tower, so it basically just follows this railing all the way up, and it does the exact same thing on the other side. So I guess I'll explain briefly what Tower Control is. When you stand on the tower, it moves in their direction, or in your direction. So what is interesting is that the only way you can take the tower is, so if I step off the tower, it'll stop moving, right? I can get back on it and it'll keep going, but if I get off of it and then wait, I think it's like 3 or 4 seconds, it'll start going back to the middle. So you can lose the tower by not having anyone on it. The other way you can lose the tower is, say I'm the only one on here, if the opponent gets two people on, it's still my tower because I was on it first, but if they kill me and then they stand on it, then it's their tower. So that's something pretty important to note, is that it's not who has more people on the tower, it's who is there first. And another basic strat of this map is snipers like to hang on this area, so having access to this wall is really important, and it also lets you kind of put pressure, as you can hide behind this from people coming that way and toss suction bombs down into that area. So that's enough for this map. The other map is the new map, and I haven't played either ranked mode on this map, so this will be pretty interesting if we get this map. I really like the way this map looks. It's basically, it just looks like It's called Camp Triggerfish, and it looks honestly just like a really cool summer camp. There's like jungle gym kind of paths that you can walk along, and getting on this wall is also pretty nice. So basically what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to ride this tower to the end. You can see the map, and this is pretty much the first time I'll see the map on tower control. So I'm really excited to play tower control on this map. It has some interesting aspects of the map. First of all, being these pathways, I don't think any other map has like rope walkways like that, which is pretty cool. You cannot ink them, of course, and if you go squid form while you're on that, you'll fall through it. So that's kind of important to note. As this is interesting path that this is taking, and it's gonna end up at this platform. Another interesting thing to note is that these gates are down. In Turf War, which I was playing last night, those were up, so you didn't have access to that whole side of the map until there was a minute left, and then these gates came down and you had access to this side of the map. One other thing that I don't think I've mentioned before that's pretty key to note is I'm gonna start on the back of this ink blotch, and if you watch the ink Zooka, it actually pushes you back when you use it, which is a pretty important thing to note, because you can fall off the map with it. So yeah, that was a 7-minute long intro, but let's hop right into one. Tower Control is definitely my favorite game mode. I really like Splat Zone. I mean, I like them all, but I really like Tower Control just because basically it makes for some interesting strategies just in terms of team play, as we actually do get the new map right away. So this will be very interesting. We have two rollers, a blaster. Blasters are great in tower control because you can just shoot it near the tower and get kills, as it'll explode above them. So I'm gonna immediately put pressure on with a long suction bomb throw as they jump on the tower immediately, but we do kill them, so that's good. I'm gonna continue to try to throw suction bombs into their zone as we actually take the tower. So I'm gonna throw some over this angle to protect us from behind that wall and actually spray the tower so we have more options to jump onto it. As they have a roller jumping on, I don't get the kill. I think he might have Krakened. No, I get the kill there. Another important thing to note, if the tower is in your own territory and you take it back, it'll automatically go back to the middle without you riding it. So you don't have to ride it all the way back. That's something pretty important to note. Someone is Inkzuka-ing, so I'm going to try to Inkzuka him, as I do get that kill, and I get that sniper too. That's amazing. So now I'm running from a roller. So we're actually making a really good push early here. Hopefully we can keep this going, as I'm actually going to get on the tower because I don't think anyone's on it. And I'm just kind of hiding at this point, as Roller Bro helps and I fall off the tower. As he jumps off the tower, which I don't really understand, as they now take the tower from us. That's okay. We still have a clear path up the middle, which is pretty nice. I'm just going to keep throwing suction bombs in that path and try to put one onto the tower now, which forces them to either jump off or to stand in a predictable place on the tower, as I get snuck up on from the side, which is pretty unfortunate. Alright, so my teammates traded there and got that guy who snuck up on the side, so we're in a decent position. Another thing that's important to say about tower control is that really it's important to go as deep as you can with every run on the tower, because any territory that you've covered on the tower, like the distance, once if you recover that ground, you go faster than you did the first time. So there's another Inkzuka, so I'm going to drop suction bomb near him and kind of force him out. See, Inkzuka's someone right in front of my face. This is interesting. Once again, I'm going to try to throw from this angle. I can't quite reach. Like I said, I don't know this map quite yet, so I need to figure out the distances that I can throw suction bombs. As I'm going to try to stick one on the tower. It hits that wall, unfortunately, and I get that guy, so that's good. As the tower is coming, and I get that guy too. So that's what's interesting about this game mode, is you basically know where people are going to be. They're going to be near the tower. As I'm going to try to Inkzooka this sniper. Don't get him, but I pushed him back, so we actually... I actually did get him. That's amazing. So basically, I pushed him back so that... so there's an Inkzooka on the tower again. As I fell off the map, that's really unfortunate. There's... basically, you just want to keep them as far from the tower as possible, because everyone knows that there people are going to be around the tower. That's, you know, it's tower control. There are going to be people around the tower. So I'm going to try to sneak across here. I do get a kill. Someone is spawning in there. I get that kill too, so that's nice. There's a third person here, and I die. Unfortunate. Looking at the gamepad, though, my teammates are in a decent position to defend the tower right now. So, important thing to note, if you're on the tower and you're losing, when the time runs out, you'll go to overtime, which basically means that you play until you are knocked off the tower, or the other team takes the tower, or you win. As we just lost the lead, so that's not good at all. Because I'm going to try to get this sniper. I do get the sniper. They're pushing pretty deep here. As I get Inkzooka'd, we need to get on the tower now. As we do get on it, so at this point, basically we had to ride this thing to the end. we have to get within 4 steps of the final position, and we do need someone on the tower when the clock hits 0, because we don't have control of it right now. So this is not good, this is not good. I don't know what my teammates were thinking there. I don't know why they jumped off the tower. You need someone on it to go to overtime, so that's really unfortunate. I feel like I did pretty well there, considering that was my first time on the map. But, yeah, I went 12-7. Pretty disappointing to lose there. I died to that Kraken, and then there wasn't really anyone else to defend at that point, which means that pretty much the entire team, including myself, got decimated. And now I'm down to A+ with 10 points. basically, I've been incredibly unlucky the past couple days, just in terms of stuff like that. I've been losing at the last second a lot, because what I was going to say before we lost the lead was, in situations like that where you're up by like 30 points with 40 seconds left, it's really not important to try to take the tower and try to ride it to victory. In my opinion, it's better to sit around a good choke point and just try to prevent them from advancing. Because going deeper at that point is just dangerous, because what happened there is we went in deep and then they came in behind us. And since we were all on their end and they had already gathered some ground, the tower moves pretty quickly to the other side of the map, and you can lose games that you're winning like that, which is pretty interesting, really. As we're waiting for one more person, and this is probably going to be the last game of this episode, but I did pretty decently. I need to figure out on this map where I can throw suction bombs from to hit crucial areas. As there were a couple times I tried to make long throws, and they just weren't. I wasn't able to reach. So, like I said, I'm gonna go down this alternate route, as most of my team will most likely go straight down the middle. So I'm going this way to give us access to this ledge, and I can jump right into the action from this ledge with a big suction bomb throw. I see someone there. They're trying to get up our hill already, because they took the tower. I'm just trying to give us some map control right now as I die to probably Splattershot Pro. Yeah. So the thing that's interesting about Splattershot Pro is it has some of the best stats in the game in terms of range to damage to fire rate ratios, but it's incredibly ink inefficient, and by that I mean that it takes a lot of ink to shoot it. So that's kind of why I don't like using it, because you have to really fill out your class to helping with like ink refill and stuff like that. As they got incredibly deep on the first run, and I'm going to Inkzooka that person, attempt to Inkzooka that person, but get bomb rushed. So we're getting donked right now, as they went really deep on the first run. And what's important here is for the team to not attempt to just go deep, but more so to cover up their progress from last run, so that it's, you know, they have to then push back through. They can't just make a lame run, since pretty much everything would already be covered in their colored ink. As we're doing a decent job, I almost get that kill, but they made it up the hill. As we finally get access to their hill, so I'm gonna go up here. As I think they made that big of a push because they didn't cover any of their side really. So that was BS. We didn't really cover any of their side. So if we can get into their side, they'll be in trouble because they'll need to cover their own side, which they haven't really done to this point. As I'm just trying to cover ground, as Roller comes out of nowhere and gets me. I'm not trying to blame teammates, but it just really feels like they've been constantly dead, and I'm just, I don't know. It's not good. That guy somehow survives. That is garbage, man. That is garbage. As they are pushing really deep. Come on. So in August, this game is getting an update, a huge update, they say, which will also allow you to choose teammates that you'd like to play with, and that's just going to be amazing, because as much as it's interesting just having to play with random people every game, it's really kind of frustrating, because sometimes you get stuck in situations like this, where not even people are bad. I mean, pretty much everyone that gets to A+ is pretty decent at the game, but you just get unlucky with like the combinations of guns that your team has. Because sometimes you get stuck with everyone has a Tentatec, and you don't have any range on your team and stuff like that. And the fact that you can't communicate via voice chat in this game makes it really difficult to kind of come up with strats on the fly. Although I can understand why they wouldn't want voice chat, especially considering most of the time you're playing with people from other countries, so it wouldn't be incredibly helpful unless there was regional matchmaking anyway. As I trade there, and of course everyone else on my team is dead also. This is getting ridiculous. As we finally get the kill on that Roller, and this guy is actually doing work. We took the tower. We're really gonna need to make an incredible push if we want to win this. I'm just gonna try to cover turf in the middle so we have a prayer of winning. That guy just jumped off the map. That's something I like to do, as I'm getting shot at from behind, and I think they killed that guy because he wasn't really paying too much attention. So I get Inkzooka, so I'm gonna start firing it up this hill. What? Alright, I was all over that guy. I'm not really sure what happened there, as they take the tower and win. I'm gonna have to play one more. That was, I really don't know. Did I play great that game? I mean, not really. I went 6-8, but I don't think people were playing the objective, really. So hopefully I can win this one and stay in A+. Yeah, I don't know. I really don't know what I could have done better there. There were a couple times that it's something that I'm going to need to work on while recording, is that there are a couple times there were kills that I would have normally gotten, but I didn't because I was trying to talk while playing instead of focusing on actually aiming my gun. But that'll just come with time and experience as we're getting into the last lobby here. One of the things I do like about this game, and there are a lot of things I like, and I feel like the things that I dislike about this game will be fixed during the August update, which the way they've been promoting it, it seems like it's going to happen August 1st, that they're going to have this big update. Basically, one of the things I like is just how quickly you can get into another game. There's not really a lot of downtime between games, maybe 20 seconds. Which is nice, just because you feel like you're getting a lot of gameplay per time that you've, you know, spent playing the game. So I'm gonna get right into this. Once again, I'm gonna follow the strat that I just took the first time, which is go up to the middle and make a big suction bomb throw, because there's a rapid blaster there, so I need to get out. To actually get a kill with my suction bomb, so that's pretty nice. I'm gonna continue to throw suction bombs over the top as we end up taking the tower, so that's good. Throw one down the middle there, as it seems like they are attempting to come down this side to play defense, as I'm gonna go up on this weird net thing and start throwing some suction bombs into their zone that way. Alright, as I'm getting shot at, but I have Inksuka currently, as I get a kill on the tower, and that's pretty decent. There's a guy behind us, so I need to... I traded. That's alright. I had perfect aim there. I didn't miss a shot, so that basically just means that he also had perfect aim and we started shooting at the same time. So I'm fine with that. I'm gonna throw a bomb near the tower and try to prevent them from coming down the middle here. Maybe try to get in behind them. It's kind of difficult as they end up taking the tower. And they jump off the tower. Oh, crap. And that's just a function of not knowing this map at all. I thought I had more room to walk there. And fell off. But that's alright, as they have Inksuka coming in, and I'm just going to throw a suction bomb over the middle. So that's seems like a pretty decent strat on this map, is tossing those suction bombs. Because it kind of pushes them back over that hill, as I kind of exploded there immediately. That was interesting. As they end up taking the tower, I'm going to throw a suction bomb onto this hill so we can take this hill. And they have a rapid blaster on the base, as I got killed from way too far away there. Definitely on this map rotation, probably a better idea to use a gun with a longer range. Maybe something like the 96 Gal. As I died to Inksuka plus lag, because his Inksuka wasn't even spraying. So that's kind of strange. As I'm gonna get up on this grating and die to the Squiffer. And okay, that guy is lagging so hard because my teammate just splatted directly on him with the roller and nothing happened. So that's pretty frustrating. I can imagine it's very frustrating for him. As we need to take this tower here. As I get a kill, finally. I get another kill, and then I explode to laggy guy. And he falls off the map. That is very satisfying. Alright, so we need to take some turf back very quickly. So I'm gonna follow this path over here and just try to take all this turf back, which will give me an Inksuka most likely, as I do get it now. So this is more just about turf management than it is about than the objective right now, as I do get Inksuka and I get that kill. So if we can get someone on the tower right now, that'd be nice. As I end up getting on the tower, there's a guy over there on their team, so I'm kind of okay. They echolocated, so my plan of sneaking up on him didn't really work. There's a guy down the hill, and I get double teamed and killed. Again, definitely not my best couple games. As I'm pushing this guy back, and there's someone behind me, and of course, since it's Dynamo Roller, he kills me immediately because Dynamo Roller is broken. And it's not looking good, as I'm gonna try to jump on the tower. I actually make it, so we're going to overtime. And of course I die to Dynamo Roller, and they take it and win. Well guys, that was definitely interesting. Lost all three games. I feel like I played pretty decently. I played really well in the first one. I played pretty decently in the second one, and okay in the third one. Again, terrible team composition. 2 Tentatex, 2 regular rollers. And it's just hard to win like that. But yeah, guys, if you like this video, drop a like, drop a comment. I greatly appreciate them, and I'll see you all next time. Peace.